I, Mitlesh Sharma, wish you all beautiful ladies and gentlemen a very good evening.
Women's health is everyone's health because a strong woman can conquer the impossible. Growth begins in little.
Nowadays, life has become so fast, where everyone is in so much hurry and keeps on running after targets like earning money, getting married, quick promotions, long vacations, buying luxurious car, to excel in profession, etc. But most important thing is forgotten or avoided by many of us, that is our health. And especially women, who takes care of everything and everyone, but her own health comes as the last priority.
To keep the body in good health is our first and foremost responsibility. Otherwise, we shall not be able to keep our mind strong and clear. Only with strong and clear mind, we can balance between work and family life. The key to wellness is the key to accept personal responsibility for our health and well-being.
When I is replaced by we, even illness become wellness. We are honored to have Mrs. Riri Trivedi with us today. Mrs. Riri is an expert in multiple wellness areas. She is certified recreation therapist, clinical hypnotherapist and trainer in integrated clinical hypotherapy and ICAI Foundation.
She is bachelor in commerce, LLB. She has specialized in kids and family yoga, that is Global Family Yoga USA. She also holds certificate in yin yoga and diploma in yoga therapy.
She uses her vast therapy to heal and help her clients to achieve transformation and balance in their personal and professional life. She conducts wellness classes, lectures, and many workshops.
She has facilitated many wellness sessions and workshops in corporates such as PNG Singapore, Gupshup, EGDI, Philips, etc. She has also conducted training in New Zealand, India, Singapore, and Malaysia. Her corporate experience enables us to connect across all the segments of the society. She is a member of Medical and Dental Hypotherapy Association in USA. She trains all age group people and it ranges from 6 to 60 years.
She is honored with ICAI Best Trainers Award, Best Consumer Understanding Award in PNG Japan, Sir CC Gandhi Trophy for Best Graduate from HLCC, and many more. Recently, she has been declared a certified member of International Medical and Dental Hypotherapy Association, the only one registered from Gujarat so far.
She is the daughter of Mrs. Madhu Patel, who was the first female practicing chartered accountant of our city. Her mother appeared in CA final examination when she was having Riri ma'am in her womb. She has got all her intelligence from her mother's womb.
Now, I would request CA Nirav Chokshi to welcome Riri ma'am with bouquet and memento. Now, I would like to request Riri ma'am to share wellness awareness among us. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you. So I'm not going to be on the dais because I do not like to be on the dais. So I'm going to be right here in the middle of everybody. Thank you for the warm welcome. It's not hypotherapy, it is hypnotherapy, and kind of heard a bit because that's okay. I'm very happy to be here because she mentioned, I'm the daughter of both my parents are chartered accountants. I almost made it, but I didn't, thank God. So I was in my mother's tummy when she appeared for her final CA in the year 1974, and like someone was mentioning, taking baby to office, she actually had a godia in her office. She was the only occupier of Ajanta Commercial Center, Ashram Road, at that time, only woman and only occupier, and she had a godia where I was with her in the office, and I've spent a large part of my childhood surrounded by CAs. I did up to inter CA, thankfully, but I realized it was not meant for me. So I've studied my law and MBA with marketing, and I'm very happy with that. It's kind of interesting to be here and addressing young chartered accountant women, because when I talk to mom, she's at home with me, she's 80 now, And she tells in her times, she was the only woman, only lady out of 3,000 boys in her college. So imagine how it would be to be the only girl in 3,000 boys in HN College of Commerce, which is now, I think, has more females probably than males. Anyway, so over to wellness. I think you guys have been sitting for a while. I mean, you women have been sitting for a while, except for one. And so it's good if you can just stand up and just stretch a bit, because sitting for a long time definitely is not wellness. So stand up very straight with your feet on the ground. And don't worry, I'm not going to do jumping jacks, because I know you have worn clothes which is not going to permit you to do that. So just take your hands slightly above your head, up on your toes, and just stretch nicely. Interlock your hands, move your spine a bit, make sure you're absolutely straight. Stretch up nicely, breathe in, and as you breathe out, come down. Yeah. Of you cry when you're stressed? Okay. How many of you go blank when you're stressed? Blank ho jate hain. How many of you start getting palpitations in your heart and start breathing fast? Okay. Same that you experienced before CA exams? Same stress, right? Stress is the same, actually. Okay. So stress is a big thing. How many of you know what is stress? You've experienced it, but do you know what is actually stress? They don't teach you in a CA class. And they don't even teach you how to manage it, unfortunately. They don't teach in any class. So when we talk of stress, I'll share with you what technically happens when you're stressed. Because when you understand that, you're going to understand why you have to manage it. Okay? There I have a slide. Stress is basically an inherent body mechanism. You know why we have stress system in our body? Why? Because we were living in the caves before. And what was our basic survival instinct? Fight. To survive. We had to fight wild animals. We had to eat, drink, live, and basically survive. Stress is an inherent part of your body. It's a survival mechanism. Okay? And what stress helps you do is, for example, right now if there was fire and smoke coming from that door, because you have a stress mechanism in your body, you will have the ability to fight that fire or run away. Agree or not?
Yes.
So stress is what fight and flight mechanism which is in your body. It is called fight or flight, which enables you to fight danger or run away. So purane zamane mein danger was what? Wild animals, fire, forest fire. And what will happen? You either fight the animal or you run away. Now, use your mind a little bit, because I assume it's here. When you have to fight that fire or run away, what is required in your body?
Energy.
Excellent, very good. So when your body needs energy, what will start happening in your physical body? Glucose will get pumped?
Yes.
Right or wrong? So there's an influx of glucose. Glucose body mein aayega, to blood has to be pumped faster. So which organ will work? So heart will beat fast. Now when heart is pumping blood very fast, okay, which other organ has to work?
Brain.
No. I know you are CA students, but this was biology you studied in 6th standard. Lungs. Very good. So lungs have to work very fast to purify the blood. Right or wrong? So your breathing will go up. So your blood pressure will go up, because heart is pumping fast. Your breathing will go up. Right? Now, the blood and energy are required in which part of your body? To fight the fire or to run away? No. I'm sorry. Hands and legs. You need maximum blood and muscle tone where? Hands and legs. So here is your body, which is so smart. Your body has such a smart mechanism that every time you sense a danger, okay, within a split second, your body will go into fight and flight mode. And fight and flight mode is what happens. In fight and flight mode, your heart rate goes up, your blood pressure goes up. Yeah. If you have to fight the fire, you need energy. So your blood glucose will go up, energy will go up, muscle tone will go up. Do you need to digest food at that time? No. Do you need reproduction functions happening? No. Excretion? No. You just need to fight or run away. So all the things that are required to do that will be start activating in your body. Your digestion will be deprioritized. Are you clear about this? This is what physiologically happens when you see a fire or a wild animal. Now, once the fire has gone away and the wild animal has gone away, your body has to come back to a rest and digest mode, which is your muscles are loose, you go like, hush, and then your breathing slows down, your heartbeat slows down, yeah? And then your body will now again focus on digestion and getting back your regular functions. Now the fun starts here. In olden times, when this mechanism was placed in our body, we had to fight wild animals and we had to fight forest fires. Beyond that, life was very simple, na? Usse zyada kuch zyada tha nahi. Now what has happened? Our life has become more complicated than that. So there are situations you cannot fight, situations you cannot flight, right? If you don't like your boss, can you really take a spear and... No. In olden times, you could. So in olden times, you went into a fight and flight mode, you did what you had to, khatam kar dala types, and then you come back, eat, kill an animal, eat, sleep and relax. Now what happens is that this fight and flight is carried forward throughout the day, situation by situation. Another interesting part is, this fight and flight mechanism is triggered not by your logical conscious mind, it is a subconscious process, automatic process. Which means, even when there is no real danger, but if you are imagining danger in your head, your body will still go into a fight and flight. So remember the times when you had a CA exam, final coming up next day? It was danger for you in your mind. Your muscle will be tightened up, yeah? And then you will, before the paper comes, heartbeat goes up, breathing goes up. All the symptoms happen which are fight and flight, stress. And the problem is, all imaginary problems also cause fight and flight. So even if you're sitting on a sofa, aram se relaxed, but in your head you're thinking of an argument you had with your mother early in the morning, or your husband, your body will still go into a fight and flight. The same things will happen. Now, fight and flight for a long time means which system will get affected first? No. Which is deprioritized the most? So first sign of stress is digestion will go for a toss. Sleeping will go for a toss. Why? Because when you're in fight and flight, the whole body's focus is what? Arms and legs, blood circulation, heartbeat going up, glucose pumping in your system, you'll get insulin imbalances, diabetes will start happening. Digestion pe to focus hi nahi hai na. Do you get this? So stress is when your breathing is fast, your heartbeat is fast, your body is tensed. Make sure you identify it the moment it happens. It can even happen at the thought of somebody. So if I tell the married people, you close your eyes and think of your mother-in-law or your father-in-law, you might actually go into a fight and flight. And the problem is you cannot fight, you cannot flight. So I have women who come, because I'm a therapist, I have women who come to me with, you know, the third mechanism, which is when you can't fight, when you can't flight, the third resort is a very advanced level of flight, which is depression. आपको भालू वाली स्टोरी पता है? वो दो दोस्त थे, फिर वो भालू आ गया पीछे, तो एक पेड़ चढ़ गया. The other dost, what he did, he was very smart. He realized that I can't run because this bhalu will overtake me. I can't fight the bhalu because he's 3 times my size. So he took the third resort. What he did is, he played dead. That is exactly what people with depression do. And that is what women who have depression do. They can't run away from the situation. They cannot fight. And the third response is complete shutdown. Escape into depression. Okay? So please be aware, this is what happens with chronic stress. This is how, with ongoing stress, back-to-back stress, your entire physiology of your body gets messed up. And which is why wellness is so important. I feel sad that some people just walk out before a wellness session. Actually, that's what I was telling. Wellness should be first, because only when you are well, you can do other things. But people do not understand the importance of wellness. It is so important to be well. Another thing, when we talk of wellness, most people know today that gymming is good. We have to work out, we have to run, we have to jog. But that wellness is at what level? Only physical level. Most of the issues today are not at a physical level. They are at a mind level. And mind wellness is something that nobody teaches in school, nobody teaches in college, nobody teaches anywhere. And that's why people like me make money. That's why I said I'm glad I didn't become a chartered accountant. Anyway, okay, so is this clear on stress? Because all of you said that stress was a big problem for you. I thought I would show you. So in stress, your body goes into an ANS, PNS, ANS mismanaged. That is, ANS basically on parasympathetic, sympathetic is a medical term. Sympathetic is fight and flight, parasympathetic is rest and digest. Both the systems have to operate in a balance. When you are all the time in fight and flight mode, your body physiologically goes out of balance. And then your hormone imbalances start happening, your endocrine glands go for a toss, your entire system, which is automatic, gets messed up. Okay, so please understand, if you feel you have stress, you must work to address it. Okay? Now when we talk of wellness and stress, how many of you do yoga? Very good. Okay, can someone tell me what is there in your yoga practice, standard yoga practice that you do? Yes, what else? You guys want to sit here? Because I'm just keeping my back to you. Or is it, so you are supposed to be sitting here? I mean, why is it so formal? So those who want to sit here, sit here, otherwise you'll keep seeing my back. Okay, so what do you do in your practice? Surya Namaskar, Pranayama.
Yes.
Okay. Anything else?
Aerobics.
Aerobics. No, I'm talking of yoga. Okay. Now, how many of you do, how many of you go to the gym and do a physical exercise there? How many of you walk? Parimal walk. Okay, very good. Beautiful. Now, when you are exercising, when you are doing gym, aerobics, yoga, primarily, which body are you working at?
Physical
body. But you know that we do not have just one body. We have how many bodies? Five or seven. Okay, seven. Wow. Well, we have many. I know of five. Yes, Silva, which are the seven? Can you please tell me? Yes. Gujarati ma bolo, absolutely. And ye bata kya practically? Mila ab shu? Very good. But ab bata naam tamhe kya? Mera wo complicated lagya. Amara Jain scriptures. Ah, okay, great. So Jainism says panch sharir chhe. Basically, 3,000 years ago, our scriptures also said we have five bodies. Okay. Which is not taught in school. The only body that we learn in school is the first body, the physical body, the annamai kosha. This is the body which you exercise, you gym. If you have a headache, you go to the doctor. If you have diabetes, it will fix your insulin, your pancreas, that is this body. Cells, nerves, tissues, organs, DNA, RNA, everything, atom, electron, proton is this body. Which body? Physical body, annamai kosha, the body which sustains with
food.
This is the body that you do go for gymming, the body that you want to wear size 0, you want to reduce, you want to tone, you want to do weightlifting, all that is physical body. The second body is your energy body. Okay? I'll give you an analogy of a TV. Everybody has a TV, no, at home? TV has a dabba. Dabba means wire, screen, hai na, andar ka jo pura hardware hai. Hardware hai, that is your annamai kosha. Once you get the hardware in your house, what needs to make the hardware work? Power cord, electricity. So that energy, electricity, power is your energy field, your biomagnetic field. So when you feel lower energy, it is the energy field that is depleted. And hence your physical body starts feeling low. Do you get it? See, these five bodies are like, you know, in a dal. Dal mein kya kya jata hai? Tur dal hoti hai, haldi hoti hai, namak hota hai, sab hota hai. आप जब डालते हो तो यू कैन कैन यू सेपरेट आउट कि इधर हल्दी है इधर नमक है व्हाई इट्स ऑल मिक्स्ड सो दिस फाइव बॉडीज आर ऑल वेरी वेल मिक्स्ड विद ईच अदर बट हाउएवर यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू डू हैव दिस फाइव बॉडीज सो ईच वन ऑफ यू इज अ फिजिकल बॉडी यू हैव एन एनर्जी बॉडी यू कैन सेंस तो आप किसी के बाजू में बैठे हो और वह झगड़ के आई है घर से वो बोलेंगे भी नहीं आपको पता चल जाएगा राइट और रॉन्ग अगर आप मूवी थिएटर में बैठे और बाजू वाला एकदम अपनी बीवी के साथ व्हाट्सएप पे आर्ग्यूमेंट कर रहा है ना वो ऐसे ऐसे बार बार कर फ्रॉम द एनर्जी यू कैन सेंस कि ये कुछ गड़बड़ है राइट सो दैट इज योर एनर्जी बॉडी रन्स योर फिजिकल बॉडी आर यू गेटिंग दिस व्हिच एवर पार्ट ऑफ द एनर्जी बॉडी इज डिप्लीटेड दैट फिजिकल ऑर्गन गेट्स इंपैक्टेड एंड व्हाई डू यू डू प्राणायाम फॉर दिस बॉडी प्राणायाम वर्क्स ऑन योर प्राणमय कोश व्हिच इज द biomagnetic field and when your biomagnetic field is good like the power in a TV your board dabla will work barabar okay third is your manomai kosh which is your mind
टीवी में आप देखते हो ना, क्या क्या देखते हो? सास बहू तो पहले देखते हो, इट्स आउटडेटेड नाउ. ओके, सो यू वॉच थ्रिलर, यू वॉच रोमांस, यू वॉच कपिल्स कॉमेडी शो, यू वॉच न्यूज, यू वॉच व्हाटएवर व्हाटएवर. सो द एंटायर गैमट ऑफ इमोशंस दैट यू एक्सपीरियंस इज योर मनोमय कोश, योर माइंड. डू यू गेट इट? No, no, and mind you cannot, mind can be anywhere. Can you see that Sony is here, BBC is here, Nat Geo is here? No, it's everywhere. Yeah? So your Manomai Kosh can be anywhere. Your brains are here, your hardware is here. Brain is which body? Annamai Kosh, physical body. But software, your program is your mind. Mind can be anywhere. Mind is the major cause of most of the wellness issues today. Any imbalance in this mind comes down into your energy field. And finally, imbalance is your physical. Okay? So whenever you do any wellness practices, okay, I go for yoga, I go for Tai Chi, I go to the gym, ask yourself, which body are you working on? Are you working on all of them? Only doing yoga, doing the, you know, the chakrasana and the ashtavakrasana and all those asanas is not going to help you in your mind. Yes, yoga with pranayama, with meditation, with dhyana, with chanting will work on all the bodies. Are you getting it? Okay. So we have a higher mind. The person who is watching the TV knows that he is a Brahman. That is your own vijnana mind, the wisdom. Do you get it? And then there is a bliss which is Anandamai Kosh. I do not want to go into the detail, but the only objective of showing the slide to you was when you talk wellness. Today there is enough data you will get on nutrition, calories, what do you work out, what you should do, walking, gymming, all that. But please understand that it is beyond this. You have to work on your energy and your mind. Any upheaval in the mind is likely to finally come down. Imbalance in your Manomai Kosh will finally, well, here you can see clear, will cause an imbalance or a haphazard flow in your energy body, will bring imbalance in the Pranamai Kosh, will finally permeate in your physical body as an endocrine system imbalance or a physical disease. That is why today 95% of the problems that people have, I'll tell you women's problems, thyroid. Yeah? Most women have thyroid. Now, do you know what is emotional cause, what is thyroid connected to? Inability to express yourselves. So 95% of the women who have come to me, unless it is genetical or unless it is at birth, it's a different story. But all the women who have thyroid problem, basically if you talk to them for 10 minutes, you will find out that they are unable to express themselves. So if they feel ki bolvano koi fayda nahi, bolvadi ki koi sambhalvano to chhe nahi yaar, chup rahe. Or if they feel ki yaar bol karu chune koi sambhal tu maru koi ghar ma chaltu nahi, or hu express karvani koshish karu chu mane koi nobody is listening to me, or very introvert, I am not able to express. What happens? The energy in your pranamaya kosh gets blocked here, and when the blockage happens here, the first gland to get impacted is your thyroid gland. Second problem women have, very common problem, is ovarian cysts, uterine fibroids. Now this is directly connected to sexuality, sexual guilt. Lot of women, I have, as a therapist I'm saying, okay, I'm not saying that this is black and white, aam hoy to aam aaj hoy ne aam hoy to aam aaj hoy, ew nothing, this is indicated. Lot of women who in childhood have been conditioned by their parents to be ashamed of sexuality, sex, sexual energy, to stay away from boys, or if they have been molested in childhood, sexually inappropriately touched in childhood, if there is anything to do with sexual energy, usually these women in their 30s and 40s end up having problems with the reproductive organs, because this energy is the sacral chakra in your pranamaya kosh gets blocked, and it leads to issues relating to reproductive organs. Third biggest problem women have, anger, directly connected to liver, and inability to love others and love themselves, or inability to forgive. If you are holding things on, मैं 5 वर्ष पहले मैंने पहला दिन से आम नहीं देखता हूँ कोई तू मैं आज सुधी नहीं भूली शक्ति क्या इस बात के बारे में you did this to me, I still clearly remember and I will never be able to कहता कहता मैं नडी पड़ता हूँ. I know a woman who is 55 और she is crying कि मारा सासू हूँ पढ़ने में आवी थी क्या रे पोखती वक्ते आम जोई दी दूँ तू. resentment is directly connected to heart chakra, which is your thymus gland. I know you are commerce students, but thymus gland is your immune system. It directly affects your immunity. Immune system goes down, you fall prey to all sorts of immune system issues, infections, and worst case, autoimmune disorders, including cancers. There has been a forgiveness project. If you search on Google, you will know in the West, they have done a lot of research. High correlation between anger, especially unexpressed anger, and cancer. Anger, if you express it, there is a good chance. But anger, gadi jao. Very, very, very bad. I have been able to say, I'm not going to out. બિલકુલ ગુસ્સો જ નથી, એમ તો બહુ શાંત છે. પછી હું એમને ખાલી બે જ વસ્તુ વિશે બોલવાનું કહું, એન્ડ યુ સી ધ બ્લડ બોઇલિંગ, ધ ટોન ગોઝ અપ, ધે હેવ અ વેરી કામ ડિમીનર, બટ ધ એન્ગર ઇઝ ઓલ વેરી વેરી ડેન્જરસ. ઓકે, સો ઇટ ઇઝ બેટર ઇફ યુ આર એંગ્રી, ગો આઉટ, જોગ, જમ્પ, ગેટ અ પંચિંગ બેગ એટ હોમ, પંચ, કિક, રિમૂવ ધેટ એન્ગર, બીકોઝ બોડી હોલ્ડ એનર્જી ફિઝિકલી. ડુ યુ ગેટ ઇટ? If energy which is not dispelled, it stays blocked. So then they come to my sessions and their hands are like this, clutching hard when they are crying and talking. And then when I say, what do your hands want to do? Oh, I wish I could have punched my mother-in-law. Then in my therapy session, I actually give them a big cushion saying, imagine this is your mother-in-law and punch. And you'll be surprised how much long they want to keep punching and kicking. You'll be surprised. Yes, please.
There is a book written by UVA.
Yes. Right, you can heal your life.
Yeah.
Yes.
And he says that every physical disease that you get is because of some or the other suppressed emotion.
Correct.
Be it anger, like for cancer, he says like.
She. Who is a she?
Okay.
She's a woman.
Yeah.
month show pehla somebody told me this and because of this I got hurt. So generally it happens ke we know like apne paas already we are working and we have lot of stuff aap to vichara but apne paas time nahi but still somewhere it is stored.
Yes, absolutely.
And whenever we remember it, it comes like atyare je vastu thai rahi che. So what is the permanent solution for this?
I wish everything had a permanent solution. But a very good question, which takes me to my next slide. Thank you. So your question will be answered in the next 5 minutes. Her question is, all this is stored, right? Badi memories to chhe, ani jode no emotion bhi chhe. To hove karvo shu joye, okay? So there are a whole bunch of things that we do for this. But first, let me ask you, where is this stored?
Mind.
In your mind, right? It is stored in your mind.
Yes.
And now where is your mind? Where is your mind located?
The mind is,
no.
There is no physical space for the mind.
So this is your hardware? Mind is where? Manomai kosha. Remember the diagram? Mind is all over. Mind is actually an energy all over your body. Which is why the mind goes off different places even if your body is here, right? So mind is a ball of energy all over your body. It is not particularly here. Actually most of the emotions are felt here and here. You don't feel it here. This is the brain. This is your hardware. Mind uses this to send messages to your body to function. But mind is not here. Samajh raha, big boss. You understand big boss, na? Very good. So if you look at mind as a ball of energy, mind has two parts, the conscious mind and the subconscious mind. How many of you have read books on subconscious mind? Lot of people. Very nice, excellent. So you know what I'm talking about. Yeah? So tell me, what does your logical mind do? Very good. Rational, logical, analytical. All the logical processing work is done by your logical mind. And how much time is it? 5% 5 થી 10% 10 નથી એક્ચ્યુઅલી તો હવે ન્યુરોસાયન્ટિસ્ટ કહે છે કે 5 થી બી ઓછું છે તમારું લોજિકલ માઇન્ડ તો બાકીનું 95% શું છે સબકોન્શિયસ માઇન્ડ સબકોન્શિયસ માઇન્ડ ઇઝ લાઈક ધીસ પાર્ટ સબકોન્શિયસ માઇન્ડ ઇઝ અ સ્ટોરેજ બધા કમ્પ્યુટર વાપરો છો ડુ યુ નો વોટ ઇઝ અ ડેટા સ્ટોરેજ બેકઅપ હાર્ડ ડિસ્ક એવરીથિંગ ધેટ યુ ડુ કેન સ્ટોર ધેર Subconscious mind is that. Everything that you see, feel, hear, experience gets stored here. Including what somebody said 13 years back, 15 years back, 20 years back. From the time you are born, even before born, I have had clients who remember being in their mother's tummy and experiencing the mother's fear. I have had clients who remember all the memories of being in the mother's tummy and hearing the mother say that I am going to get an abortion done and should we get this baby out or not, and the baby already from that moment knows that I am not wanted. And these are real cases, I am telling you. That is why in our thing they say garbh sanskar, that when a woman is pregnant you should have good thoughts. Why? It is not like feel good, do good, all. That's not the case. It is real scientific. A fetus from 4 months onwards can experience and feel everything. It doesn't have grammar, doesn't have conscious mind. But the database is already getting updated. It can feel, sense, see, hear everything. Please understand. So from that time to right now, everything your experiences is getting recorded here. Permanent memory. And unfortunately, to disappoint her, it cannot be deleted. Okay? Everything that you have experienced in your life can never be deleted from your memory. It can be overwritten. So those things can be small, you can overwrite with many happy memories and that will go away, you will not recollect it. But it is there and it will remain there. Are you getting this? So in your subconscious mind there are files and files, endless files of father, mother, brother, sister, uncle, auntie, eating, school, teacher, school bag, cycle, everything you have experienced. And subconscious mind does not understand logic. Matra storage che. And as subconscious mind, tamaru involuntary functions, fight and flight, ne pan trigger kare che. As subconscious mind, tamari hormone system, immune system, endocrine system par asar kare che. And logical mind nahi. Do you tell your heart to stop beating and take a break? It is automatic. It is subconscious mind. But when you are stressed, it will beat faster because it is coming from here. Which is why now it is so important that everything that you have stored here, all the garbage, will play out in your life. And it is very important to understand that, so don't feel so miserable. The storage is there, it is permanent, but you can override it with positive experiences, positive images. Subconscious mind ma storage logical nathi thatu. It does not understand logic. Okay? And I will explain to you how subconscious mind no file kevri te bane tamne kahu atyare. Everybody close your eyes. Close your eyes. You are allowed to think of anybody and everybody. Think of anyone you want. Anything, any person. But do not, and I am again repeating, do not think of a black chimpanzee wearing red skirt. Don't think of the black chimpanzee wearing red skirt. Now open your eyes. What can? So don't think of my mother-in-law. Don't talk about her. What will come first? So subconscious mind doesn't understand logic. So when people tell me, "And para chokra ne kitlo pochu, tu ghata na par, to magaj ma su image jaye." Ghata. Usi ma fail nahi to, koi sab hai fail. So, tumhe mind ma su program karo. And now do you understand why? You just experienced it. Think of the black monkey, black chimpanzee with red skirt. How many of you have small children at home? Very good. Excellent. Now these children, they don't have this. This is still not fully developed. So whatever you tell them goes literally in their head. Use it. Don't khavanu ethu na bu. Ethu. Kudka na maris, tofan na karis, pumo na padis. What are you saying? You are actually saying, telling them what they should do. Right? So, for yourself and for children and whoever else understand, that is why we have to always tell ourselves what we should do and not what we should not do, even if it is total lies. So if your son is very weak, you should not say, kya bo, bicharo na bro che, you know what you do, tumhe adoshi ne ko, padoshi ne ko, phone par mummy ne ko, aaya, maadot padi jaye, jo bari maadot padi liyo. You are continuously reinforcing maadot. Even if it is total outrageous lie, you must actually say, are boss true. And you will start seeing the change. I've had clients who've done this and they've observed phenomenal changes in their children. Yeah? Now same applies to you. How many times you say things that you don't want to happen and that happens? Raise your hand. Mare nathi joy tu ej bariyu che. Abhe khabar se nathi joy tu ej kem aave che. Because nathi joy tu is a big thing here. Do you get it? So, yeah, law of attraction, those who have seen that. But this is how it works. Because subconscious my image pehla jaye. Baki logic ko to pachhi aave.
Subconscious mind jo bagu store karte ho, how do we forget? Wo bhuli gayi. Aap sumari ka.
Nothing forget. You have not forgotten. You have covered it up. It's like saying ki mari carpet ni niche mein sadela fruit chupa di dita che. Ab wo thoda vakat pachhi bhuli gayi chuki aap carpet niche fruit che. I have forgotten. Everybody believes that it doesn't exist. But eventually, after a few days, it will start stinking. It will start smelling.
So, I have done bhuli gaya.
That happens for a different reason. So what happens is, when your mind and body are not together, your body does automatic work, mind is not there, you will forget where you have kept your key. This is mindfulness issue. You will only forget when you are not present in that task. Please remember this. If you are fully aware with your mind and body, you will not forget. Are you getting it? Yeah? Okay, so do you understand this? How all this is stored?
Yes.
So there is a file for father, there is a file for mother and everything. Now for example, I get the clients who say this very frequently, women again, working women. I was brought up in a family where my father used to always shout at us. He would get very angry. I was a very angry father. He was very angry. First, I was very angry. And madam, I was very angry. Now, I have a husband who is also doing the same thing. The other scene is, I've grown up with a father who is extremely angry and I'm also now angry. My mother used to beat me up every day, now I'm beating up my children and I don't know why this is happening. I have huge anger issues. Why this happens? Again, you have a huge file of anger and father over here. huge file of anger. Whether your 5% logical mind tells you you should not be angry, angry is not good. If you have grown up with a big file of father being angry or mother, one of them being angry, that is what will come. And you will probably start manifesting that same experience. Or you will do completely opposite, which means you will do everything but get angry. So even when you have to get angry, you will not get angry. And as a result, you will end up attracting an angry person in your life. This is how this whole cycle of anger works. It actually goes to generations. So when I'm talking of wellness, I guess this is too much for you to take in today, but because a question came up, I'm kind of going a bit more in depth and answering, but this is how your subconscious mind plays out. If you have a deep-rooted belief system, ke mare to amara gharma badhane diabetes chhe, aur amara gharma to chhe ne badhi ladies ne a gynec problem hoye chhe. Aa tamne kehvama aavyu hoshe. Tamne doctor pase jaso to doctor bhi emoj kese kya genetic chhe. But hove epigenetics is a part of genetics which is now saying that even genes alter their structure based on environment, which means if you stop believing that this is not going to happen to you, it may not happen. I'm not saying it will not happen. Most of the things that people talk about are our gharma to third pedi thi diabetes hai, kyun chukru janam tani sa diabetes hai, aa diabetes mere paas aa type conditioning ke liye. And this is true, this is for ridiculous things, but people say it is running in my family. Biladini beak humne akha gharma tron pedi thi chhe. Biladini beak doesn't come in your genes, I'm telling you that. It's a belief system. It comes from here. Yes. So, I'm not going through how so basically, if you want to reprogram your mind, you want to do something to change your mind programs, you have to work through your subconscious mind. And working through your subconscious mind can happen through multiple ways. If you do yoga, through meditation, through yoga nidra, you have to be in an altered state, means your logical conscious mind should not be interfering. Then only you can bring about a change in your subconscious mind. So I had in mind a 5-minute quiet kind of a meditation, five to six minutes. Are you okay with that? It may not be the real thing because it takes a while for you to get into the alpha theta zone which is required to go into your subconscious mind. But we will try. Okay, you will probably get the experience of what it is like to relax, what it is like to calm down. I will be asking you to take your awareness to different body parts and also focus on your breath. These are the two things, these are the two hooks which will keep your presence here and you'll be able to work through it. Okay? So everybody, you can sit back, relax, close your eyes, keep your hands on your thighs. Take a few deep breaths in and out. Breathe in from your nose and out from your mouth. In from your nose and out from your mouth. A few rounds of breathing in from nose and breathe out from the mouth and then continue normal breathing. Feel your breath going in and out of your body. Allow your breath to flow through your body. Keeping your eyes closed, because when you close your eyes, 40% of your brain automatically gets relaxed. Vision occupies 42% of your brain. So closing your eyes, make sure that your brain is half relaxed already. Bring all your awareness to your toes. Relax the toes of your feet one by one. Relax the soles of your feet and relax your ankle joints. Loosen up the ankle joints and relax them. Feel the relaxation moving up into your knees. Allow your knees to loosen up. Relax your thighs and loosen up your hip joints. Allow the entire lower part of your body to completely and totally relax. And now bring your awareness to your abdominal area. Feel your breath moving in and out of your body through your abdomen. Relax your abdominal muscles. Feel the relaxation moving into your chest. Allow all the muscles and nerves of your chest to completely and totally relax. Allow your heart and your lungs to relax. Observe your breath. Your breathing would have slowed down. Feel your heartbeat. Allow the relaxation to flow into your shoulders. Any tightness or tension in your shoulder area, just relax and let go. Relax your upper arms, your lower arms, elbows, all the way till your palms of the hands and your fingers. Allow your fingers to relax and allow both your arms to feel heavy and relaxed. Allow the relaxation to also flow into your back. Let your spine relax and all the muscles and nerves around your spine completely relax. Allow your lower back, middle back and upper back muscles to loosen up, allowing every vertebra in your spine to completely relax. And feel the relaxation flowing in your neck, back of your head, scalp of your head, down to your forehead, your eyes. Let your eyeballs feel heavy and sink down. Let your eyelids feel very heavy and relaxed. Allow your face muscles to relax. Allow your face, your lips to give a gentle smile which will soften up all the muscles of your face. Feel the entire body from head to toes in a beautifully, calmly relaxed state. And in this wonderfully relaxed state now, take a deep breath. Feel your body. And connect to a memory, a recent memory or an old memory where you felt very happy, very confident. A memory where you were super good, where you felt at the top of the world, where you felt very, very confident about yourself. It could be any small thing, any small memory. And feel in your body how that feels to be happy, to be positive, to be confident. Feel that memory as if it is happening right now. Because your subconscious mind doesn't know the difference between real and imaginary. Feel it as if it is happening now. That happiness, that confidence, that positivity. And allow your body to experience that positivity and happiness right now, wherever in your body you feel it. And take a long deep breath, and with the breath allow that positivity and confidence to spread into every cell of your body. Imagining, visualizing every part of your body absorbing that beautiful energy of confidence and positivity. And then gently visualize yourself using that confidence and positivity for the rest of the day today. See yourself for the rest half of the day, anchoring that positivity and confidence in whatever that you do. And when you're ready, slowly and gently you can rub your palms and open your eyes. Place them over your eyes and open them. Welcome back. How many of you were able to feel that, remember a memory of happy, confident memory? Not everybody can in the first attempt, but very good, excellent. Were you able to anchor it? Were you able to feel it? So that came from your subconscious space. Okay? And that is how You connect to positive memories, bring them up, expand them, create more and more files so that over a period of time, the negative memories do not keep popping up and coming back into your conscious space. Is that clear? Okay. So I think that's about it. I had written down some women issues that we have dealt with. I'm not going to go through that because of lack of time. But any questions that you have about whatever we spoke, actually, to be honest, in 1 hour, it is very difficult to share a concept, to make you experience it, to also make you go through what you have to go through. So it's kind of really, really a very squishy, tightly packed stuff that I've tried to give you. Any questions that I can answer? Yes. સાંભળવું પડે છે તમારી ચોઇસ છે કે તમારે સાંભળવું પડે છે એટલે પડે છે આમાં કેવું છે કે જે ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ હોય આપણને યાદ રહે જે ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ ના હોય ના યાદ રહે સેકન્ડલી હા તો એમાં તમારે શું કરવાનું મેમરી ઇમ્પ્રુવમેન્ટના શોઝ હોય છે એમાં જવાનું બીકોઝ દેટ ઇઝ સમથિંગ આઈ કેનોટ હેલ્પ યુ વિથ Yeah. To answer to the question you had asked to the earlier panel also about, you know, why, you know, you have stress, you have to help your mother tomorrow. I wanted to add something, but I didn't want to butt in because it was somebody else's session. As women, it is important to keep our boundaries. Which means, આપણા માં કન્ડિશનિંગ થયું છે મારા મમ્મીએ બી કર્યું હતું જો એ જમાનામાં ભણેલા ગણ્યા હતા કે સાસુ આવું કહેશે તો તું શું કરીશ યુ બેટર બી પ્રિપેર ફોર સાસુ નો સાસુ ઇઝ અ બિગ હાઉ બીકોઝ વિમેન લાઈક મી ઓનલી વિલ બીકમ સાસુ વેરી સૂન So sasus are equal fear of the bahus. I'm telling you that. Today's generation sasus are equal number of sasus in terms of therapy. Because they think the bahus, bahus are obnoxious, the bahus are very irresponsible, the bahus don't understand. So sasus are also women. And sasus are equally scared of having bahus in their life. I'm telling you. I told my son, please don't come with a bahu to my home. You please go elsewhere because I don't want to live with a bahu. So please understand that this whole sasu thing is a cultural thing. And very important, don't go by this thing ki sasu ke kaam karwanu. You have to be very clear on what you are willing to do, and this has to do with your self-worth. If you feel that you are a doormat, everybody will treat you like a doormat. If you think you are not a doormat, nobody will treat you like a doormat. I know most women today, even if they are qualified, they can be the big MBA MD of a company. Still at home, they are like doormats because they have been trained to be like doormats. Please understand, being a doormat is not a good thing. It is not glorifiable. It is not a virtue. Okay? It is nonsense. So please don't be doormats. And at the same time, don't be abusive to your mother-in-laws also. Just maintain your balance. Okay? Because I know I have mother-in-laws who come to me with really, really bad, serious psychological issues as well. Okay, any other questions? Yes? That is only the problem. First of all, you cannot fight with the world. You cannot change anybody. You only can change yourself. Today, most of the people come to me with problems of other people. My husband is like this. My bahu is, you know, madam, my boss, if you meet my boss, you will be convinced that he is such a bully. I mean, anybody in my place will have left the company. But please understand, you cannot change anybody. Nobody wants to change. Do you want to change? If you don't want to change, the other person also thinks the same way. So you cannot change the environment, you cannot change others. You can only work on yourself. And the day you accept yourself the way you are, you will learn to accept others. Are you getting this? And most of us are not accepting ourselves. Like I just heard somebody say that, oh, you have to do, you know, balancing. You have to be the perfect woman, balance a house, balance children, balance career. No, if you can't balance, please accept it that, no, I'm incapable of doing this and it is okay. Today most women have issue of over self expectation too much from our own self baaki na logo koi pressure nahi create karta pressure aapne j create kariye che I can't be the perfect mother I want to be good in my career I want to be a good cook when my friends meet they discuss recipes I also should be able to discuss recipes my child should also feel that I'm available all the time for him because I have to be a good mother cannot have it you know the first step is to now I don't sound like a corporate trainer I have nonsense that you have to be an overachiever and you have to be great. I feel the best way to start is accept. Anathi na tu marathi bhai. And who accept karu chu mari jaate nathi na tu and I'm okay with that. I don't feel inferior. Accept it. Nathi jimma jawa tu yaar, su karu. Nahi biju kai karo. પણ આપણે શું છે જીમમાં નથી જવા તો એની જોડે ઝઘડ 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 કરીએ છીએ આખી લાઈફ કઈ પણ કરો અથવા પછી બી હેપી વિથ યોર ફેટ બી હેપી વિથ યોર વેટ એન્ડ ડોન્ટ ડ્રિંક સો એક્સેપ્ટન્સ વેરી વેરી ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ એન્ડ વેન યુ એક્સેપ્ટ યોર સેલ્ફ યુ વિલ એક્સેપ્ટ યોર ચિલ્ડ્રન યુ વિલ એક્સેપ્ટ યોર સાસુ યુ વિલ એક્સેપ્ટ યોર હસબન્ડ યુ વિલ એક્સેપ્ટ યોર બોસ વેન યુ ડોન્ટ એક્સેપ્ટ યોર સેલ્ફ યુ ડુ નોટ એક્સેપ્ટ એનીબડી ઇન યોર લાઈફ એન્ડ વેન યુ ડોન્ટ એક્સેપ્ટ યુ વિલ ઓલવેઝ બી અનહેપી યુ વિલ બી અવે ફ્રોમ વેલનેસ Are you getting this?
Yes.
I hope I have made my point in whatever way. All the best for all the nice working women. As a joke, I had put on Facebook, I'm going to start a guilty moms club because I think all of us working women have a lot of guilt. We are not able to do enough. Daily, no? Yeah, I'm also going through that, but I'm working on myself. And like I said, I accepted that even though I'm a therapist, I'm not perfect. I do have guilt. So today I had to go home at 4, but I had this workshop, so my kids are like, Saturday you are out. But I'm going to deal with it. So you all deal with it. I have my brochures here, which talks a lot about my work and what I do, so feel free to pick them up, or if I can ask Silva to just distribute. Thank you very much for your time and patience.
Thank you, Riri ma'am. You truly said that this is very short time to understand wellness concept. And you have shared very energetic and informative session. Thank you so much. I would like to request Natasha to for vote of thanks.
Thank you, Riri ma'am, for your wonderful speech. And we all have understood the importance of wellness in our life, and we will surely be more aware for our health and rather be balancing with our professional and personal, including wellness. Thank you so much.